Concepts of Oncology, a channel exclusively for learning about cancers. Subscribe for new videos every week. What is Marjolin's ulcer? Marjolin's ulcer is a malignancy developing on a chronic scar. This chronic scar could be due to trauma, cellulitis, burn. Why is Marjolin's ulcer called so? In 1828, Jean Nicholas Marjolin described a lesion that developed in degenerating scar tissue. Although others had previously described cancers developing in burn scar, but Marjolin's ulcer name was given to these malignancies. Other names are scar cancer, cicatricial carcinoma, Kangri cancer. What is Kangri cancer? In Kashmiri people, there is a cultural practice of wearing the Kangri, an earthen oven underneath the flowing gown. It predisposes to repeated burn injuries and subsequent development of Marjolin's ulcers, popularly called Kangri ulcers. How does a chronic scar convert into malignancy? Any wound on skin, if left to heal by itself, undergoes multiple trauma and regeneration process, leading to chronic inflammation. Area of chronic inflammation always has immature cells with higher rate of mutations. This leads to chances of conversion of normal cells into malignant cells. What are the criteria for labeling a skin cancer as Marjolin's ulcer and not a primary skin malignancy? Ewing formulated a set of criteria to establish the relationship between trauma and the development of cancer. The cancer must arise within the boundaries of the scar or wound. Evidence of trauma or the pre-existing ulcer as evidenced by the wound or scar. The absence of any precursory or similar neoplasm on the site of the trauma wound prior to the development of the cancer. The histologic variety of the cancer must be compatible with the tissue found in the site of the trauma or scar wound. The interval time between the trauma ulcer and the onset of the cancer must be appropriate. A period of 1 month has been proposed as the minimum acceptable time between the trauma ulcer and the onset of the cancer. What is the time lag between primary pathology and the development of carcinoma? Characteristically, there is a time lag, or latent period between the primary pathology and the development of carcinoma. In general, the average latent period for Marjolin's ulcer has been reported to be between 20 and 40 years. Based on time lag between development of wound and Marjolin's, two types of malignancy is described: acute form, where lag is less than a year; chronic form, where lag is more than 1 year. Acute form is more common in elderly, as their skin is more prone to genetic damage and faulty DNA repair due to aging. So who are more predisposed to Marjolin's ulcer? Males outnumber females by about 3:1 ratio. This could be due to genetic differences or to a simple male bias for the predisposing conditions. The commonest region of the body involved are the lower limbs and inflection crease, where repeated traction prevents timely healing. How is Marjolin's ulcer different from primary skin cancer? Primary skin scar developing on healthy skin spreads by mainly by lymphatic route. In case of Marjolin's ulcer, scarred skin is fibrous area poor in lymphatics, hence lymphatic spread appears late. But this also confers protection from immunological recognition on the early stages of Marjolin's ulcers. Dense scar prevents adequate immunological attack on tumor, leading to continuous accumulation of mutations. By the time Marjolin's penetrate scar into healthy tissue, there is aggressive lymphatic metastasis. Hence growth of Marjolin's beyond scar, either in skin or in deeper planes, is a bad sign. So in some studies, Marjolin's ulcer is having worse prognosis than primary skin cancer. One more reason could be late presentation due to misdiagnosis of non-healing wound. How is Marjolin's ulcer diagnosed? Any new wound over scar, especially if raised or chronic non-healing wound, must undergo biopsy. Tissue biopsy should be taken from the suspicious areas of the edge as well as the central area. What is the histology of Marjolin's ulcer? The commonest histological variety seen in Marjolin's ulcer is squamous cell carcinoma. However, Marjolin's is not necessary squamous cell carcinoma. Rarely, other histological varieties like basal cell carcinomas, malignant melanomas, fibrosarcomas, liposarcomas can also be found in scars. What are the imagings done in Marjolin's ulcer? For primary tumor staging, CT scan, MRI are useful in assessing involvement of deeper tissues. CT is better for bone involvement, while MRI is good for soft tissue involvement. For regional nodal staging, in addition to clinical examination, CT or high-resolution ultrasound is done. As lung is most common site of metastasis, so CT thorax or chest X-ray is done. It is important to see on MRI the involvement of major vessels and nerves and distance from bone, so that line of excision may be planned. Surgery remains the mainstay of treatment for Marjolin's ulcer. Wide surgical excision with margins of around 2 cm is preferred. Defects following resection should be skin grafted, except where the bed may not be suitable for a skin graft, then a flap may be used. Amputation is indicated when deep invasion makes local excision impossible, when there is bone or joint involvement, or when excision would severely impair function. Regional node dissection is done in case of involved nodes or sometimes prophylactically when chances of nodal mets are high, like when there is growth of tumor beyond scar or patient may not turn up for regular follow-up in case observation is chosen. Marjolin's ulcer is relatively less responsive to radiotherapy and chemotherapy. This is due to decreased vascularity and extensive fibrosis in surrounding tissue, but this may have a role in palliative setting. Concepts of Oncology, a channel exclusively for learning about cancers. Subscribe for new videos every week.